animal approved for consumption is being grown right here in Indiana.
Aqua Bounty is processing GMO salmon, that could be hitting the market next year. So we got a tour of the facility to see exactly how it works.
Yeah, Fox 59's Kelly Rinke shows us more tonight.
Each one of those orange blobs is a yolk sac, and attached to it is a fish.
Those tiny things swimming in there are baby Atlantic salmon. About 90,000 of them came to Indiana from Canada.
We feed them constantly.
In a few months, they should look like this. But this batch at the farm is a little different because they are not genetically modified.
So this is the hatchery.
That's where Pete Bowyer comes in. He's Aqua Bounty's facility manager in Albany, Indiana. His team is processing the country's first genetically modified animal for human consumption, and the FDA approved it in 2015.
A wild Pacific salmon is very deep in color.
I got a tour of the facility with a small group of other journalists. The company wants to be very transparent to the consumer before these GMO salmon can hit the market in late 2020.
I think about food insecurity and I think about climate change, and using genetic modification and gene editing allows us to meet those challenges.
The company's president, Sylvia Wolf, says it took them almost 30 years to get approval because they were the first to go through this process. Aqua Bounty created this fish with a gene from Chinook salmon and a gene promoter from ocean pout. They say it grows faster than conventional salmon.
And the requirements that we had to meet guarantees the safety of the fish to human.
Can other facilities produce salmon this way? And number two, can other animal industries use this technology to increase their production and efficiency?
Bob Rohde is a lab manager at Purdue University with a background in fish farming. He's not concerned about the product either, as it gets closer to possibly hitting your nearby grocery store or restaurant.
Frankenfish shouldn't be something we're afraid of. It solves problems. It doesn't create problems.
In Albany, I'm Kelly Rinke, Fox 59 News.
Aqua Bounty says they're discussing selling the salmon to several grocery stores and schools. In 2016, a coalition of fishing and environmental groups sued the FDA for its approval.
All right, let's talk about our weather right now.